What do you need?
I don't know you. Perhaps you're robbers and will hurt me. Prove your respect, and then maybe I will let you in. For now, go. I don't need problems. Oh, what a nice item. Too bad it lacks herbs. That item makes me happy. I accept the gift as a sign of your respect. Come in. Welcome. I hope I didn't make you angry. You must be careful, as my shop was robbed. The robbers took many valuables. Are you a buyer or a seller? Ah, you are a detective. Are you looking for Houdini? Let's make a deal. If you are a detective, then find a highly valuable item for me. In return, I will give you the key to the town hall. You must then set the clock on the tower to the time when the tavern opens. Houdini is rehearsing there. Agreed? Wonderful! I've been looking for this for many years. You will find an ancient scroll inside the court jester. Be careful, it's very old. Bring me the scroll, and I'll give you the key.
Thank you.
Mr. Detective, nice to see you again. You certainly have an amazing ability to suddenly disappear and then reappear. Okay, I won't waste your time. The other day, Mr. Boston, the constable, came to the theater. Remember him? He was looking for you. He said it was urgent. Unfortunately, I don't know what he wanted. You know police officers. Everything hush-hush and top secret. So, Mr. Perry, I think you need to go to the police station. And don't forget about Mr. Houdini. I'm still waiting for him to grace our theater.
Detective Perry? Where have you been? I couldn't find you. Andrew and Fox's fingerprints finally arrived from London. Now you'll be able to examine them and clarify what's going on. You can find the letter in the locker with the card file. The fingerprints from the crime scene are on the table. Thank you.
Thank you.
I've done everything I can for you. Continue your search.
Now you will make me rich. You're a good detective. Do you want to work for me? I have many other things for you to find. If you find them all, I'll give you the key. No? Then get out. The key is mine. I also need to repair my telegraph machine. I'm waiting for an important message.
Hey, what are you doing? Let me out!
Okay, take what's yours. How about another deal? I'll slide the key under the door and you will free me. Agreed? Fine, take the key. Now, set me free. Thank you, Detective. You taught me a valuable lesson.
Thank you. Okay. Where are my props? Cursed storm! I can't perform like this! Can't you see I'm busy? Please come to my show if you want an autograph. Oh, wait. You're not an actor or a fan, are you? I beg your pardon. I don't know why I'm still looking for my things. I've already searched these boxes 100 times. What? An invitation? Let me see. The Mr. Fox Theater. It's been a long time since I performed there. You're looking for Andy Fox, aren't you? I can help you, but I need to find everything for my show first. I performed tonight, but I lost half of my props in the storm. If you can find something, anything, I'd be grateful.
I'm sorry, John, but I need to prepare for my show.
Wonderful, John. Now, help me perform a trick. I have to rehearse it at least once, and I need an assistant. Please, lock the handcuffs. As for the key, throw it away. Now, seal the chest. John, I hope you're still here. Please, slide the screen. Add some mystery.
Amazing, isn't it? The audience will love it.
Regarding your case, when we created the time machine with Mr. Toad, Fox's assistant, why are you surprised? I also had a hand in its creation. So, Mr. Toad, a little man with great wit, and I discovered that if one activates every sphere at once, the time machine will open a portal to the world of oblivion. It exists and doesn't exist at the same time. Panopticon is, a world of illusions. We haven't been able to study its nature or its qualities yet, but Mr. Toad has always been interested in it. That's all I know. Thank you for your help, John. I'm going to continue rehearsing. I have only a few hours before my show starts. Good luck.